the Lord told me recently to buy some shares. Now, I've never bought shares. I didn't even know you could do it, you know, simply. So I had to go onto moneysavingexpert.com, because he's the genius on all this stuff, isn't he? Martin Lewis or whatever. So I had to buy, and it said, oh, there's a couple of websites. So I thought, oh, okay. So I'd found this website where you could buy shares. And the Lord said to me, I want to teach you about money. And that means I'm going to have to remove some stuff out of your life. I thought, oh, okay, what's that going to be like? It says it's going to be hurt, but it's going to be good. How does that work? Well, you have to be invested in something for me to work on it. So should we do that, Paul? I said, okay, I'll do it. Because, okay, go for it. So he tells me a company to buy. I never even heard of this company. I'm in the middle of worship. This is it. I'm in the middle of worship. I've been worshiping for an hour, and the Lord just comes in front of me and says, okay, Paul, it's time to buy shares. What? And you need to buy shares in this company. What? A couple of days later, I found out this company, you can buy shares in it. So I talked to Catherine. Catherine graciously allows me to do this. So I put some of our meager savings into these shares. And so now I'm part of this company. I am bought in to this group of people. And then as soon as I buy shares in this company, they drop. So for 2 weeks, it just goes. And I tell you, the stuff that came up in my heart, the stuff like, oh my goodness, what am I doing? I'm wasting money. This is, and the Lord's going, wasting your money? Oh yeah, it's your money. Hold on, yeah, it's your money. It's not, if I'm really not bonded into money, it doesn't matter whether I lose it or gain it, does it? Why is this affecting me? And my heart is going through the middle. So much stuff is getting raked up just by these shares losing about 30% of their value. And then after 2 weeks, I then say, well, Lord, you've done a lot in my heart. Is that it? He says, no, another stage. And he said, I want this, the shares are going to reach this amount. And the next thing you will hit is greed. Greed. I said, really? So the same thing that causes you to fear when you lose it, it will cause you to greed when it gains. Okay, right. So well, what do I do? He said, I want you now to bless the company. I want you to dedicate the next day to declaring in the heavens goodness over all the families that work for that company, prosperity over their marriages and over their lives. So I had a day that I had other stuff in it, but every so often I would stop and I'd go into the heavens and I'd just bless the families of who are involved, all the people involved, everyone. Would you believe the next day starts to go up? When it's recovered about 15, you know, half of the value, I can feel the greed. I can feel this is a great way to make money. This is it. I can just see it. We can just, we just buy the shares the Lord says, and I can just see it. I've got a ministry coming, and all this junk is coming up in my life, and the Lord's going, what does it matter whether it goes up in value or down? All the money is mine. Do you not believe I can give you any money whenever I need? It's all about your heart, Paul. It's all about your heart. So I'm repenting as it's gaining in value. He told me the exact amount it would reach to. I couldn't believe it when it reached it. I was like, Lord, he says, well, there's some more unbelief. Just let that out, Paul. See, I can speak these things. And in that whole process, I discovered again, if my heart is detached from greed and selfishness, and I'm not living my life for my own life, then boy, you can make a difference in the world. And the people who are making a difference in this world, it's not the ones that are visible that are making the difference. It's not the visible ones. It's the hidden ones who are not hidden in the heavens.